Hey everyone, it's Julie, and this video is all about curating my tarot deck library. As you can tell by the title, it is a VR to Mindy over at The Artistry of Tarot. And her video is actually a VR to Nancy at Nancy the Texas Rose. And so in a way, my video is in response to both of those ladies, as well as Grace from, her channel name is Mary Grace Faroon. And all three of them have been discussing, you know, deck curating and their collections. And I think this year and even around this time, I've been seeing a lot of videos on people who are culling their collections, and deck culling is one of my favorite tarot topics. I love watching videos on people who declutter and cull their collections, as well as people who bring in hauls and increase their collections. So I mean, those are my two favorite, two of my favorite types of videos: collecting and hauls, and then decluttering. I just think it's great to see people who get excited when new decks come in and are trying new things, especially if they're new to tarot and still trying to figure out what it is that they connect with in terms of the type of decks that are out there. And then I also love seeing the satisfaction of people who have culled their collection and minimized it, and now they feel that sense of catharsis. I've certainly been on both sides. I could for sure relate to a lot of what Nancy had to say in terms of the feelings of malaise, her feelings of and the overwhelm. She sees herself as a minimalist. And certainly I wouldn't call myself a minimalist, but I do strive to live more lightly and intentionally. And, I do like my deck collection to be on the smaller side. And while, I would say that my experiences aren't exactly like Nancy, where she, was talking about how, you know, she had decks on the way that she wasn't really even excited about. My experience is more along the lines of what Grace has been discussing in her videos, which is that, you know, she'll get a deck, and then after a month, she's over it, right? Which I have mentioned in previous videos of mine that I have a very bad pattern of, just buying the deck. I love it. I love it to death. You'll hear me singing my praises over a deck in a video, and then I'm rehoming it like in the next month. Another thing that really resonated with me that Grace had mentioned is kind of this longing to go back to a time when, you know, she only had the one deck that she had been using for ages, or, you know, a couple decks. And that certainly does strike a chord, because it reminds me of when I first started really getting back into tarot and learning. And I had my Llewellyn. And then a little later on, I had my Everyday Witch. And those were my two kind of ride or dies at the time. And it really, it wasn't all that hard for me to make a decision of, oh my gosh, which deck should I work with? It was a no-brainer. And that kind of easygoing process is something that I sometimes miss. And I wouldn't trade my deck collection for anything. I realize how privileged I am to be able to make those choices in the decks that I work with. And I do find such joy in my collection. So a couple of changes that I've made while listening to these conversations is, one, coming from Nancy, she said that she has started to look at her collection like a library, which I thought was absolutely brilliant. And I believe she got that concept from someone else. I can't remember. Maybe Simon over at the Hermit's Cave. But in any case, just that little change of mindset really, really helped me. When I think of, say, a book collection, which I don't actually have a huge book collection, but I have books that I will reference that give me joy, that I know I'll reread. And that's how I also want to view my decks as well. I mean, with the book collection, I definitely could relate to Mendy when she was talking about how she would, you know, she moved her huge, colossal collection of books into her husband's house after they got married. And that was me too for the longest time. And I moved quite a bit. So, but I culled that down. I got rid of maybe 90% of my library collection, and I'm very happy with what I have. And so I treat my deck collection, or I've started to look at my decks in the same way. So again, for me, it's not about the number of decks that I have. I am not looking to hit a specific number, because I certainly don't do that with my books. But it is very important to me that I use the decks that I have, or I know that I'll refer back to them at some point, or at the very least that they spark joy for me for whatever reason. And so I'm not just keeping them out of some odd obligation. Over the year, I have actually been culling my collection intermittently. That is something that I don't struggle with. I know for the most part fairly quickly if a deck needs to go, but another kind of change I've made, and this was influenced by Grace. She was talking about how just seeing all the decks on her shelves overwhelmed her because of just the chatter. And so she put the decks that she wasn't using into a sleepy time box. And that really helped. And so I was like, wow, that's a great idea. I already have a huge box that was being used for my kind of purgatory / undecided, we're on a break type box. So I just decided to make room for another category, a separate compartment, to make room for decks that I knew I wouldn't be using for the next few months, and just put them away, even though they all fit on my shelf. And that really did help as well. So I really liked that. So now my box is, you know, the purgatory, which is filled with decks that I'm going to rehome. And I believe that part of the box is empty as of now. And then I have the we're on a break, the undecided, like I don't know whether I want to keep you or not. And then the kind of in hibernation decks. At this point, I do feel as though I'm at a very good place with my collection. And moving forward, I will continue to curate based on whether a deck that I wish to bring in is going to offer me something different or something new to what I already have, which is a sentiment that Mendy has expressed and that I've heard other people in the community express. And it's something that I want to cultivate moving forward. And I have, over the year, you know, I've been practicing this very thing, and I've had some successes and also some misses. And I don't give myself a hard time for those failures, because it will be a learning curve and it's just a matter of practicing. It's not going to be a quick habit that I build. I do still have some decks that I am waiting on. One I won't be receiving until early next year because it's a Kickstarter. And then three decks I should hopefully be receiving in the next month or so. And all of them I feel will add something new or different to my collection. And so I'm excited about those. And that's it. I just wanted to come on and chit chat with you about where my process is as of now for curating my deck library. Thank you to Mendy and Nancy and Grace for these thoughtful conversations. I would love to hear your process when it comes to deck collecting and deck culling. How do you go about building your collection and then decluttering it? So feel free to drop a comment below or do your own video. I would love to see it. I hope you all are well, and until the next time, much love and take care.